सो डेटा प्रेजेंटेशन इट इज द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक हियर. इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द रिसर्च रिपोर्ट राइटिंग, राइट? सो इन द रिपोर्ट वी आर गैदरिंग और गेटिंग द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ डेटा इन द डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दैट इज कम दैट वी आर प्रोजेक्टिंग इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द रिपोर्ट. सो वॉट एवर द डेटा वी आर गेटिंग दैट इन द क्लाइमेक्स और एट द एंड ऑफ आवर रिसर्च, एनी काइंड ऑफ रिसर्च, दैट what are the different way to present, how we can present those data in effective manner so that it will reach to the targeted audience, right? So coming to the data presentation, it is nothing but as data are generally voluminous and they need to be put in the compact and presentable form, right? That's what it is going to be the report, right? It should be compact or short and presentable form, right? So that it can be easily understandable. This class deals with presentation of data precisely so that the voluminous data collected could be made usable readily and are easily comprehended, right? So that's what they are generally three form of presentation of data. Generally, the first one is the textual or descriptive presentation, second one tabular presentation, and the third one diagrammatically presentation, how we can present. So first one, the textual presentation of data. As the name indicate, text, right? Whenever we are giving the text message or the text form of the email, so that going to be in textual presentation, the data described within the text, right? The text is going to be the way or media to present the data obtained from the research. When the quantity of data is too large, big size, this form of presentation is more suitable. So let's clear with the case. The first case or example we can say, right? In a Bandh Kal, whatever the Bandh or Bharat Bandh or something like that, given on 8 September 2005, protesting the hike in price of petrol and diesel. So five petrol pump were found open and 17 were closed, whereas two schools were closed and remaining nine school were found open in the town of Bihar. Any town, Patna, let us take the example, right? So when Bandh called on 8 September 2005 by protesting against the hike of the petrol and other fuels increase. So what is happening here? You can see that these kinds of things you need to elaborate, right? You have that presentation of data should be in the textual form only. Then only it can represent the actual thing what happened. Coming to the tabular presentation of data, in tabular, as the name indicate, table, right? Table from table it became tabular. So in a tabular presentation, data are presented in rows, right? Read horizontally, or columns, read vertically. How it is in table horizontally and vertically. For example, see the table 4.1. In next slide, I will show you the tabulating information about the literacy rate. How much peoples are educated or literated, right? So in that it has three rows for male, female, and total. You can let us see the here, right? It has three rows where the male, female, and the total. This is the row, okay? Male, female, and the total number of literacy rates. So literacy in India by sex and location percent, right? So what happened here in these three rows, three column, for urban, rural, and total. Here you can see three column are the urban, rural, and total. Okay, so three rows, three column. Okay, so it is called a 3x3 table giving nine items for information in nine boxes called the cells of the table. Right, that's what here nine data, 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This side also, right? Column and row. So like that, each cell gives information that related an attribute of gender, male, female, or total. with a number, like literacy percentage of rural people or urban people, or the total literacy percentage that we could see at the bottom, right? The most important advantage of tabulation is that it organizes the data further, statistical treatment and the decision making, right? So that's what classification used in tabulation is four kinds, right? So in tabular presentation, there are four types: the qualitative tabular presentation, quantitative tabular presentation, temporal and spatial, right? So coming to the first one, qualitative. So when classification is done according to attributes such as a social status, physical status or nationality, it is called a qualitative classification. For example, the 4.1 here, we have taken the example, right? The attributes for classification are sex and location, which are qualitative in nature, right? Here sex, male, female, or location like urban area or rural area. So it is going to be qualitative. So this is the source of this table, that Celsius of India. Celsius of India in 2011, the literacy rate related to population aged 7 years and above, right? So this table we can take as an example for the qualitative classification of tabular presentation of data. Coming to the second one, the quantity, right? In quantitative classification, the data are classified on the basis of characteristics, which are quantitative in nature. In other words, these characteristics can be measured quantitatively. Okay. For example, in 4.2 table, you can see the age here, age groups, height, right? And the production, income, etc. are the quantitative characteristic. The number we are bothering about here, quantity, how much quantity it is. The classes are formed by assigning limits called class limits for the values of characteristic under consideration. An example of quantitative classification is given in this year. You can see that distribution of 542 respondents by their age in the election study in Bihar. So here you can say age group in year 20 to 30 year, number of respondents, 3 members, or percentage, it is going to be 0.55%. 30 to 40 age group, it is 61 respondents. 40 to 50 age group, 132. So like that, how many people responded? So here the number, that's what number of respondent, that's what it become quantity, right? Quantitative, right? So this source of this data is the Assembly Election Patna, Central Constituency 2005, and that Sinha Institute of Social Study Patna. From there, it has been taken as example of the quantitative classification of tabular presentation of data. Coming to the third one under this tabular, the temporal classification. In this classification, time becomes the classifying variable and the data are categorized according to time, right? That's what temporal time. Time may be in hours, days, weeks, months, or year also. For example, you can see here years. In 1995, sales in lakh. How much sales? The yearly sales of tea shop, whatever the tea, Lipton or Tata Tea or that Red Label, whatever, from 1995 to 2000. So in 1995, it was 79.2 lakhs, right? And here, whereas in 1996, 81.3, 1997, 82.4. So in which time, ultimately, what is the theme of this one? Which time, right? What happened, right? How much sale occurred that we are presenting in this kind of tabular formation, that is called a temporal, which indicate the time. Then spatial classification. When classification is done on the basis of place, location, it is called a spatial classification. The place may be a village, maybe town, maybe any block, district, state, country, or anything, right? In table 4.4, you can see here the export from India to rest of the world in 2013-14 as share of total export percent. Here you can see in USA destination, here location, destination, which area, right? So in USA, United States of America, the export share was 12.5. Germany 2.4, in European countries 10.9, in UK United Kingdom 3.1, Japan 2.2, Russia 0.7, China 4.7, West Asia 15.3, other Asia 29.4, and other countries 18. So here, which location? That's what, right? The spatial means location done on the basis of place or destination. Then it will be. So that is the four types of tabular formation. The tabulation of data and a part of the this one. To construct a table, it is important to learn first what are the part of good statistical table. Which tabulation form it can be suitable. When put together systematically, these parts form a table. The most simple way to conceptualizing a table is to present the data in rows and columns, as we have seen in the four examples, along with the some explanatory notes. What it is indicating, the table is saying about what that should be mentioned. The tabulation can be done using one-way, two-way, or three-way classification, depending upon the number of characteristic involved or number of characteristic available. The good table should essentially have the following characteristics. The table number, very, very important, because if the number it is going to increase, we have to choose the number. Table number is assigned to a table for identification purpose. If more than one table is presented, it is the table number that distinguishes the number one table from another. It will separate from one table to another, right? It is given at the top or at the beginning of the title of the table. Like generally, table number are whole numbers in ascending order. Now, one, two, three, four, right? So, if there are many tables in a book, so it will be in like that. The subscripted numbers like 1.2, 3.1, etc. So are also used for identifying the table according to its location. For example, table number 4.5 should be read as the fifth table of the fourth chapter, and so on, like that, right? Over 4.5, 4.6, 4.7, like that, it has to go on. Okay, so characteristic title. The title of the table narrates about the content of the table, right? It has to be clear, brief, and carefully worded so that the interpretations made from the table are clear and free from any ambiguity, right? It finds the place at the head of the table, screening the table number and or just below it, right? What for it is, what is the table contain, what it is showing, like that, right? The captions are column headings. At the top of each column in the table, a column the designation is given to explain figures of the column, right? This is called a caption or column heading, like a 4.5, right? You can see that the stubs are raw headings, like caption or column headings. Each row of the table has to be given in the heading. That's what we have seen in the previous table. The designations of the rows are also called stubs or stub item, and the complete left column is known as stube column, right? A brief description of the row heading may also be given at the left hand top of the table. That's what in 4.5 we have seen here, top of the table, right? We can see in the here, you can see how the 4.5, it is called here the table number, the table title, the population of India according to workers and the non-workers by gender and location in 2001. That is the title, right? Here, column headings. Here, column heading workers. It is this row, it is showing about the workers, main workers, marginal, and the total, right? Here, units. You can see here raw headings, urban, rural, or all. The source of the data, the note about the table, the figure are rounded to nearest crores, and the body of the table. So, likewise, we can present here, right? The body of the table. The body of the table is the main part that it contains the actual data. The location of any one figure data in the table is fixed and determined by the row and column of the table. For example, data in the second row and the fourth column indicate that 25 crore females in rural India that were non-workers in 2001, right? Here you can see here, right, in rural area, how much people they have non-workers, 18-25, like that we can go on, right? Unit of the measurement, the unit of measurement of the figures in table actual data should always be stated along with the title. If different units are there for row and column of the table, these units must be stated along with the stops and the captions. If figure are large, they should be rounded up, and the method of the rounding should be indicated. Like you can see here in again table 1.5, here the note, the table 4.5 presents the same data in the tabular form already presented in through case 2 in the textual presentation. But the way of presentation, you can see here the raw headings, the body of the table, the column or heading, captions, note, source, title, number, and all those things can be presented in effective manner. Okay, source, the main source that we have seen in the down here, the source from where it has been taken. It is brief statement or phrase indicating the source of data presented in table. If more than one source is there, all the sources are to be written in the source called source area. Source is generally written at the bottom of the table. That's what here you can see, bottom of the table from where the data has been collected. And the note, special note, note is the last part of the table. It explains the specific feature of the data contained of the table, which is not self-explanatory and has not been explained earlier, right? That's what here you can see in the note we have.